Hello, and welcome back to Wendy's Way. Today is episode 5 in our new series called Gems from Grace and Glory. It's a daily devotional offered by my friend Marilyn. We recently finished off Psalm 119 with her. We kind of jumped in the middle. I think we got 4 days on the end of that. And today she started in Proverbs 2. Verses 1 and 8. I'm so glad that you decided to join me. I hope you'll keep joining me. My goal is at least 5 days a week on Gems from Grace and Glory. All right, let's read from Proverbs 2, verses 1 through 8. My son, if you receive my words and treasure up my commandments with you, making your ear attentive to wisdom, and inclining your heart to understanding. Yes, if you call out for insight and raise your voice for understanding, if you seek it like silver and search for it as for hidden treasures, then you will understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of God. For the Lord gives wisdom. From his mouth come knowledge and understanding. He stores up sound wisdom for the upright. He is a shield to those who walk in integrity, guarding the paths of justice and watching over the way of his saints. That's a pretty good one. Oh, sorry, I have a little itchies going on today. This is Marilyn's devotional. A love letter sent to you from God. She's quoting here, I believe, Thomas Watson, and the publication is Body of Divinity. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Colossians 3:16. Study this scripture. It is a copy of God's will. Be scripture men, Bible Christians. Search the scripture as for a vein of silver. This blessed book will fill your head with knowledge and your heart with grace. There is majesty sparkling in every line of scripture. There is a melody in scripture. There is that blessed harp which drives away sadness of spirit. How sweetly does this harp of scripture sound? What heavenly music does it make in the ears of a distressed sinner, especially when the finger of God's Spirit touches this instrument? Oh, then, search the scripture. Had I the tongue of angels, I could not sufficiently set forth the excellency of scripture. It is a spiritual telescope. That's some perspective, isn't it? It is a spiritual telescope in which we behold God's glory. It is the tree of life, the oracle of wisdom, the rule of manners, the heavenly seed of which the new creature is formed. The scriptures are profitable for all things. If we are deserted, here is spiced wine that cheers the heavy heart. If we are pursued by Satan, here is the sword of the Spirit to resist him. If we are diseased with sin's leprosy, here are the waters of the sanctuary, both to cleanse and cure. Oh, then, search the scriptures. Read the Bible with reverence. Think, in every line you read, that God is speaking to you. The ark wherein the word was put was overlaid with pure gold and was carried on bars, that the Levites might not touch it. Exodus 29:14. Why was this but to give reverence to the word? Read with seriousness. It is a matter of life and death. By this word you must be tried and judged. Read the word with affection. Get your hearts quickened with the word. Labor that the word may not only be a lamp to direct, but a fire to warm. I like that perspective too. Read the scripture not only as a history, but as a love letter sent to you from God, which may affect your hearts. Pray that the same Spirit who wrote the word may assist you in reading it, that God's Spirit would show you the wonderful things of His law so that the word will become effectual. I like the perspectives put forth, the way they, I know there's a specific word for it and I'm not going to come up with it, the way they illustrate the words, in a visual nature. I'm a very visual learner. I learn by watching. I learn by listening. And when you can tell me something that paints a picture or makes a direct comparison like this does, it helps me. It opens my eyes a little bit more than just reading it myself, and a little bit more than, I won't say then the Spirit shows me, because He shows me what I'm ready for when I'm ready for it, when He wants to show it to me. All right. This has been episode 5, Gems from Grace and Glory. It looks like maybe we're back a little bit into devotions offered by others, but the source is still Marilyn. And I will continue to share with you what she has shared with me every day. I may not stick on exactly the course because I have months worth of material saved up that I can share with you in the future. I thank you for joining me again today. I pray that the good Lord, who blesses me each and every day of my life, will bless you as well, today and always. Amen.